Hello viewers, welcome to linuxhelp.com. Let's see about how to install dstart tools on Ubuntu 16.4. First of all, dstart is a versatile tool for generating system resource statistics and replacement for vmstat, iostat, netstat and interface statistics. Dstart is another handy tool for monitoring system during performance, tuning test, benchmarks or troubleshooting. You can monitor additionally MySQL database activity, better percentage into battery percentage info for laptop, number of DBus connection, fan speed and NFSTD, postfix, system temperature sensor, power usage and etc. Dstart allows you to view all of your system resources in a real system. You can add any combination of dstart command with option as per your requirements. Example, compare bandwidth utilization with a particular Ethernet or any interface link you have to apply for this dstart command. Before you have to install the software, you should update the operating system using a command of apt-get update. The updation process has been going on. After you've done the updating operating system, you have to install the dstart tools apt-get install dstart. The installation process has been going on. The installation process was completed. The major information detail about getting from a dstart tools: total CPU usage, utilization, total network usage, page statistics, system statistics and etc. etc. First you have to run the command using a dstart. It will show the detailed information about the total CPU usage, here disk total, here network statistics, here it will be a paging statistic, here it will show the system statistics for the. If you want to show detailed information about memory, included user, buffer, cache and free memory, and swap memory and virtual memory, detail about using a dstart command. For dstart hyphen hyphen memory hyphen hyphen swap, here it will show the memory usage of detailed information, here it will show the swap information, here it will be the virtual memory information. These are all the structured by used memory, buffer memory, cache memory and free memory. Here swap memory and used and free memory. Here it will show the virtual memory of major page statistics, minimal page, minor page statistics and allocation, and free details about the virtual memory. The user, if you want to add the multiple CPU on this single system, the dstart command, it can be so the detailed information for the multiple CPU information. It display each CPU structured by a user time, system time and idle time, steal time and waiting time for a process activity. If I give the dstart command for a CPU information, hyphen C, it's may mentioned by a CPU information. For you have to give a multiple CPU on single system, you have to mention the number of the CPU name, and I have to given a total information of the CPU total. It will show the entire detail about the CPU information details. Here it will show the CPU usage, disk information, here it will show the network statistics, paging statistics, system utilization statistics. The CPU usage, it will be structured by a user, system, idle, wait, the steal time and waiting time. If you want to know the detailed information about disk utilization and a disk input output utilization for a particular disk, if you check it out, the total disk utilization for a SDA1, just give a command for dstart hyphen hyphen disk, then hyphen hyphen input output utilization, then you have to mention the options like hyphen d is mention a disk, then you have to mention the partition name of disk. I have to declared by SDA1. It will show the disk utilization here. Here it will show the input output utilization for the particular disk of SDA1. If you want to know the detailed information about network utilization for a particular interface link, just you have to using this command like dstat hyphen hyphen net hyphen capital N till used to mention the network statistics for the interface link. Here we have to mention the name of the interface link. I have to mention ENS33. ENS33, this is my interface link for a LAN connection. These are all the information for receiving and sending data per interface link of ENS33. Then if you want to know the detailed information about the top CPU and top CPU time process using the most CPU time in minutes and top disk input output activity and top disk black input output activity and top memory and top latency usage in the single command using a dstat hyphen hyphen top CPU top. Here it will show the entire detail about information for the CPU process and CPU time process and input output process, black input output process, memory process for the processing using the CPU time. These are all the latency structure of the using this dstat command output. Then if you want to know the detailed information about the CPU, disk, memory, process, load and network usage, which is very common for a basic troubleshooting when server is load too high, just using a command of dstat hyphen hyphen CPU hyphen hyphen memory hyphen hyphen processor hyphen hyphen load hyphen hyphen disk hyphen hyphen net. It will show the detailed information structure like a CPU, memory, process, load and disk and network statistics for the dstat commands. The command of using dstat, it will be show the information about listen and establish sync time and waiting time, close time, structure about the TCP, UDP and circuit connection. Just type the connection for a following below. Dstat hyphen hyphen TCP hyphen hyphen UDP hyphen hyphen socket. It will be show the output of a structure for a listen time, established time, synchronized time and waiting time and closing time for a transfer control protocol and user datagram protocol and for a socket. If you want to set a time of every delayed time for a getting information detail about the corresponding given command, dstat hyphen hyphen time hyphen hyphen CPU hyphen hyphen process. Here I have to delay timing of getting output information about the dstat command. Here I have to declare the number of 5. It will get the information detail about every 5 delay timing for a corresponding operations. Here it the system time, it will show the process time of the execution for a command. The by default dstat command, it will delays 1 second and count is unlimited. If you want to display statistics every 2 seconds and delay with the 10 count of any combination of as per your requirement. The below combination, so about CPU and process statistics every 2 seconds with the 10 counts. Dstat hyphen hyphen time hyphen hyphen CPU hyphen hyphen process. Here I have to mention the delay time. Here I have to mention the number of count. Here it will show the 10 count of process detail information with the delay time of every 2 seconds. Then you have to see the important options where using a dstat command to store the reports to the file for the investigation. You can do by using this below format by any combination. Dstat output. Here I have to mention the path of file to be stored in the system, apt dstat output .csv is a format of file extension. Here I have to mention the what are the detailed information getting the output of this file hyphen hyphen CPU hyphen hyphen memory hyphen hyphen disk and hyphen hyphen IO. These are all the output for I given a command for corresponding process. Process details information will be stored in a file name of dstat hyphen output.csv. Then we have to checking out the file from a getting output information from using a command of dstat. This is a file of we have to store the information detail about from getting a dstat command. Just you have to open this file. The file has been opened. It will display the entirely detailed information which convert into the Excel format. If you want to know the other options for using a dstat command, just referred by a man page of dstat command. Thank you for watching this video. Please subscribe our channel Linux Help. To more further videos, visit www.linuxhelp.com. For any queries, mail to support@linuxhelp.com.